Well, that just weakened your military. You got them using outdated, old technology, and the weapons are, you know, China and Russia developing far greater missiles and weaponry than what the U.S. has right now. So the U.S. military is primed for, you know, for destruction. It's a setup. And, you know, the military, U.S. military, there's some up at the top that know it. That's why you have all these generals that's been resigning from the U.S. military. And also, they trying to, you know, they turn whistleblowers to try to alert everybody that, look, there's treason going on in the U.S. Secrets are being sold to China, to Russia, and, you know, America as a whole is being sold out. And the military top generals, four-star generals, are alerting people, they're blowing the whistle. But still, you got a lot of people here in America that don't know that. They still think that America cannot be taken down. That America is the top military power in the earth. Man, Russian missiles are more accurate, far faster, and able to evade any missile shield that America can put up. They're far more advanced than anything that the U.S. has, and man, America won't stand a chance, even with NATO. And as the scriptures say, the Most High, He set up banners. And those banners are going to be blowing that destroying wind. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. All this is due to the will of Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shah. Now you got these up at the top, they trying to play God. These elite bankers and financiers, the grand viziers, you know, they like to play God. But at the end of the day, Yahweh is God. And His will stand in the earth. So, again, this is Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 2. It says, "And I will send unto Babylon banners. They shall ban her and shall empty her land." What's going to empty the land? Those thermonuclear missiles. That's going to lay America waste from coast to coast. You know, if there's a bunch about that, it says, "For in the day of trouble, they shall be against her round about." Yeah, this is what time we're coming to. You see them gathering as I speak. Verse 3, "Against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow." Right, against him, those that have the nuclear missile technology, you know, the bow is the modern day silo. Where the modern day arrow, the missiles, are being shot from. So I say, let them bend the bow. Prepare your missile to be shot. That's what it said. Again, against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow, and against him that lifted himself up in his brigandine, and spare ye not her young men. Destroy ye utterly all her host." The host is the army. A host is an army. So all the U.S. military be wiped out. Most I say spare none of her young men. That's what time we are in. That's the time we are in. Verse 4, "Thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans." This, America, is the land of the Chaldeans. You know, because the Chaldeans back in the ancient world was associated with Babylon. Those were like the elite of their day, of their time. Under the king, of course, under Nebuchadnezzar. We had the Chaldeans. They were like the soothsayers. This this is referring to these here in America that, you know, like I say, they think they're calling the shots, but no, they're going down too. A lot of them going to be brought into captivity. Some of them going to be destroyed. A lot of them are going to be destroyed. Let me read that again. It said, thus, this verse 4, thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans. You know, the slain going to fall in the land, this land of America. All the, you know, police force here, the UN, you got the UN here on U.S. soil, getting ready to spring into action of the female homeland security. All of that host are going to fall in the land of the Chaldeans. It says, and they that are thrust through in her streets. So you'll see a lot of killing here in the streets of America. You're going to see a lot of slain and a lot of people fall dead here in the streets of America. That's called judgment. That's the Most High's indignation. The fury of the Most High, and the wrath of his fury will be poured out here in America. You people will drink of that cup. It said, verse 5, for Israel had not been forsaken, nor Judah of his power of the Lord of hosts, though her land be filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel. So Judah, let's say Israel had not been forsaken, nor Judah of his power. It said Israel and Judah because the nation of Israel was split into two kingdoms. The kingdom of Israel, the northern kingdom, and then the kingdom of Judah, the southern kingdom. Because when you look at the map, Judah was the southern portion of Israel. Judah had that southern portion. And Israel and Samaria and all that was up north. So that was, you know, Israel was the northern kingdom, Judah was the southern kingdom. So the Most High is saying Israel had not been forsaken of his power, nor Judah. Israel had not been forsaken, nor Judah, of their power. And the two are coming back together in these last days. Israel and Judah are coming back together, and that's the whole point in having this stick. Showing the 12 tribes of Israel as one nation. You know, one nation. You Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans make up the nation of Israel. So, and that's according to Ezekiel the 37th chapter, another prophecy that we at Great Millstone go into thoroughly and break it down the correct way. But back to what we're speaking on, there's going to be an elect out of the house of Israel that's going to be preserved, because the nation of Israel is not forsaken of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. And through that elect, through that one-third of the nation of Israel, the Most High will reestablish the nation. So ultimately, all Israel will be saved. You know? But only an elect are going to make it through this time of Jacob's trouble, through this tribulation that's coming. Only an elect. This is the time that we're in, man. The Most High getting ready to deal, man. I mean, he's dealing right now, but the Heavenly Father is getting ready to really show you who he is. And it's just like in the time of Egypt with Pharaoh, the Most High let Pharaoh rise to, you know, unprecedented heights for his time. You know, the Pharaoh at the time when Israel left out of Egypt, Pharaoh was at a, man, Most High let him come to great heights so that Most High could take him down to great depths and show his power. Well, that's where we are at in history, modern history today. This so-called white man and America and NATO have been brought to great heights through the power and will of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai, which was orchestrated and carried out through the left-hand side. by way of Satan and his demonic host. They work with this white man to bring him into great power in these last days. So now when this white man gets to dealing and doing his thing, ain't no one gonna be able to stand up against him. That's why it says that the Most High is gonna lift up a standard against him. And that's, he's gonna have to give certain of the elect spiritual powers to withstand this flood and this enclave that's getting ready to come, you know, in the earth. No one's gonna be able to stand outside of the will of Yahweh Bashim and Yahweh Shah. So that when the Most High take this man out of the way, you will know that there is a heavenly power. All of that atheism is going to go right out the window. Because Yahweh Shai, the only begotten son of Yahweh, is coming back with a mighty hand and great glory. And every eye, it's like every eye shall see him, and every knee shall bow. He's coming back with a mighty hand. Like I said, all that atheism and Big Bang and evolution is going to fly right out the window then. So, we are at a critical point in history. And this is the time to make your stand. But the scripture, you know, also says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 6, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. So when all chaos breaks loose, you know, everybody's going to be, it's going to be, you know, run for cover. It ain't going to be time to go through the scriptures and trying to learn this and calling brother, what's that breakdown? Or, you know, going on YouTube and trying to pull up Great Millstone to get the, Revelation 18 breakdown from the apostles. It's too late then. By that time, it's too late. It's gonna come a time where all bets are off with Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. That time is here. It's not here, it's coming. Right now, it's still, you know, for the elect, there's still doors of grace and mercy still extended and open. Those doors are, that door is narrowly closing, or it's narrow. That window of grace is real narrow. So yeah, man, it's a, day out here today. Satan don't never want this word to come out, but certain, you know, certain lessons just strike certain nerves. And you know, you see that even with this white man. Certain videos he'll try to prevent from being uploaded. Certain other lessons, you know, he just let go. Although they wish to totally shut this internet off, but that is coming. They will, eventually that will happen. Because at the beginning of this month, October, the internet was supposedly given over, you know, certain IP addresses and whatnot been given over to the UN. And I'm even noticing you're seeing more and more censorship. So just get ready to see even more censorship. As time progresses, by the end of this year, it's gonna be, you're gonna notice it's gonna be hard to upload these videos. They always do it piecemeal, bit by bit. back to the scriptures is Isaiah. Jeremiah, chapter 51, verse 5. For Israel had not been forsaken, nor Judah of his power, of the Lord of hosts, though their land was filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel. Flee out of the midst of Babylon, and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, for this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. That's all I've been saying, man. This is the time of the Heavenly Father's vengeance. The Lord is not coming back with well wishes and peace and blessings. He's coming back to take the wicked out. He's gonna take the wicked out, man. It's a long time coming if you ask the elect. The earth is gonna be destroyed. So this is what the Lord is coming back for. So if you don't want to get or have part in that, then you got to come out of Babylon. You got to forsake the ways of this place. You got to come back to the law, statutes, and commandments to the best of your ability of the Heavenly Father. You got to rehearse these righteous acts, which is recorded in the book of Judges, the 5th chapter. Gonna get that because that lines up perfectly. You know, we got to rehearse the righteous acts. So here we go. This is Judges chapter 5 verse 11. They that are delivered from the noise of archers in the places of drawing water, there shall they rehearse the righteous acts of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai. So we've been talking about the archers, those that bend the bow and all that. That's those who had the nuclear weapon. So here it's saying, they that are delivered from the noise of archers. So what's the noise? That's the noise of the nuclear missiles detonating. They're going to give off a great noise. Against him that bended, let the archer bend his bow. Most High set up banners round about America. It's getting ready to take this place out. So if you want to be delivered from the noise of the archers, this is what you're going to be doing. There shall they rehearse the righteous acts of Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai, even the righteous acts toward the inhabitants of his villages in Israel. Then shall the people of the Most High go down to the gates. So this is the time of rehearsing the righteous acts, which is coming back to the law, statutes, and commandments of the Heavenly Father. That's what time it is. If you want to, you know, escape the noise of the archers. Now, if you don't care, you say, well, I don't care, it's just a missile. What should I care? To be destroyed like that, then fine. It's only for the elect of Israel anyway. Only the elect are going to rehearse the righteous acts anyway. So the rest of you will be destroyed. But it's not going to be just easy like you think it is. Because a lot of you going to wait out that time if you defeat the missiles. A lot of you going to wait out your time in concentration camps. When you're being tortured, beat. Heavenly Father only knows what else, man. The Lord is going to be as if a man did me the a lion, or flee from a lion and a bear met him. And escaped the bear and went into a house and leaned on the wall and the serpent bit him.